Hello guys, welcome to my channel Maths Pursuit. Today we are going to look into exercise 5.1 question 4 beat 15 from chapter 5 called arithmetic progression. So let's see what exactly is given in question number 4 beat 15. Coming to the question, it is given that which of the following are APs? If they form an AP, find the common difference D and write three more terms. And the given number sequence is 1 to the power 2, 5 to the power 2, 7 to the power 2, 73. Now let's see how we can solve this question. Coming to the solution, here we need to find out if the below list of number forms an AP. If AP, then we need to find the common difference D, and we need to also find the next three terms. Guys, the question is again very simple. Just we need to find out if the given list of number forms an arithmetic progression, and if the list forms an arithmetic progression, then we are going to find out the next three terms. And guys, we very well know that to determine if the list of number forms an arithmetic progression or not, we need to find out the common difference D. Once we get the common difference D, then the picture will be more clear whether that particular number series forms an arithmetic progression or not. So let's see. Now the given number sequence 1 to the power 2, 5 to the power 2, 7 to the power 2, 73. Or we can write the number sequence as 1 to the power 2 as 1, 5 to the power 2 as 25, 7 to the power 2 as 49, and 73 as it is. Now putting the number sequence in a tabular form. Guys, as usual, I always prefer to put the number sequence in a tabular form so that our calculation will be easy and without creating any confusion we can move ahead. So we are creating a 4 column table with 3 rows and naming first cell as first term, second cell as second term, third cell as third term, fourth cell as fourth term. Now putting the first value 1 under first term, 25 under second term, 49 under third term, 73 under fourth term. Now naming A1 to first term, A2 to second term, A3 to third term, A4 to fourth term. Guys, we are naming A1, A2, A3, A4 respectively to the terms so that it would be easy while doing our calculations among the terms. Now let us move ahead and find the common difference D. So we very well know that for finding the common difference D, we need to take the difference of the consecutive terms. Now we also start from the end of the term, like from the 4th till 1. So here we are going to find out the difference between 4th term and 3rd term, that is A4 minus A3, that is equal to 73 minus 49, that is equal to 24. Similarly, difference between 3rd term and 2nd term, that is A3 minus A2, is equal to 49 minus 25, that is equal to 24. Again, moving ahead, like similarly, difference between 2nd term and 1st term, that is A2 minus A1, is equal to 25 minus 1, that is equal to 24. So guys, we could see that we are getting a common difference of 24 while finding the difference between the consecutive numbers. Therefore, as the common difference D is equal to 24 among the consecutive numbers, hence this list forms an AP. As the number sequence is an AP, so we need to calculate the next three terms. So guys, as per the question, once we determine if the number sequence forms an arithmetic progression, then we are going to find out the next three terms. And we very well know that in order to get the next term, we need to add the common difference to the current term. That means we are going to determine the next three terms, that is A5, A6 and A7. So for finding A5, we are going to add the common difference to A4 so that we can get A5. Let's see. So here A5 is equal to A4 plus D. So that is equal to 73 plus 24. A4 is 73 and D is 24, the common difference. So adding this together, we are getting 97. So moving to A6, A6 is equal to A5 plus D. So A5 is equal to 97, which we got in the above step, and D we know it is 24. So that is equal to 97 plus 24, that is equal to 121. Similarly for A7, A7 is equal to A6 plus D. A6 is equal to 121, we got in the above step, and D we know 24. So for that reason, we are adding 121 plus 24, that is equal to 145. Therefore, the next three terms are 97, 121 and 145. That's all guys. Hope you all got this point or got these calculations. If you still have any any problems or concerns, kindly write to me in the comment section of this video. Definitely I will get back to you once I see your comments. If you guys really like my videos, kindly subscribe and let your friends know. This will motivate me to create similar videos in the future. Thank you. Bye.